The builds are the BSU ULIS. Information Literacy Development Solutions is the library education program intended to enhance the students' competence in the 21st century skills, specifically on information literacy. This aims to improve the students' ability in understanding their information need, identification of information sources, retrieval, evaluation, and ethical use of information, serving as an intervention to the increasing misinformation and spread of fake news in the different information platforms. We welcome you to an Information Literacy video series brought to you by the BSU Library in cooperation with DevCom Action Media Radio Station with the students of College of Information Science, Department of Library and Information Science.
Are you working on a paper and figuring out where to start? Do you have research work and don't know where to begin? Do you have an assignment that's kind of hard to understand? Or maybe you just simply need to confirm something you've read a little while ago? Well, that seems like you need to learn how to identify your information need. What does it mean by identifying an information need? Identifying information needs means that you fully understand what information would satisfy your questions or inquiries. There are a few important steps in fully recognizing your information need. First, you begin with task initiation. What happens in task initiation is that every time you need to be supplied with information or answers that are not readily available, and you feel the urge to suffice what you know or even know more about it, you are engaging in an information-based activity. This includes researches, assignments, essay writing, position papers, or simply whenever you need to learn about something. Task initiation involves identifying what is given and what is asked from the activity. Just like problem solving, the given are provided details for you to begin your information task. And the asked are the missing information you have to look for. Both of these information would help you understand the task. So how would you do that? First, write the things you know about the topic. Then, identify the things you don't. From that list, try to figure out ways on how to obtain the missing information based on the clues you can get from the information you already have. Although it is important to use all the background information you know about the topic, you must also recognize your lack of knowledge about it. Because when you don't acknowledge your ignorance about it and assume that you already know everything, you are narrowing down your information processing to the things within your knowledge only. If so, you are more prone to motivated reasoning. Motivated reasoning is where you decide within the limit of your personal knowledge or belief. You're missing out on other knowledge or information that is way bigger than what you know. In other words, it's impossible to recognize your need for information if you immediately think that you don't need to know anything at all. The next step is to identify the query. After understanding the things you need to know, you must identify what questions you should ask. Take note that questions pertaining to information-based activities have contexts and specifications. Questions without a defined context are ambiguous and might seem to have multiple answers. For a simple example, you might be thinking about this ball, but your teacher is asking for this ball. Another, this rock, is very different from this rock, and of course, different from the rock. You see, defining context helps identify questions that would provide specific answers. This leads us to the next step, which is to know the scope of your information need. This is where the specifics come in. After defining the context, you would be able to specify criteria to filter your questions from broad to specific. Broad questions help you see a wider picture on your information task. while specific questions help you target the most precise answers. Broad questions could retrieve more answers, and specific questions retrieve more details about the topic. But both types of questions could help you organize your information-based task, as it guides you to identify limits and denote which aspects are needed to be expanded or explored. So remember, when identifying your information need, you must first assess what you already know, acknowledge that you do not know everything about the topic, list questions as your guide, define the context and set limitations for your questions, and finally, organize your questions from broad to specific. This will surely help you effectively identify your information need. We hope this video has been helpful for you. Happy searching!